God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Today we come to the halfway mark of our Lenten journey, where we venerate the holy life-giving cross. We put the cross before us as a reminder of the impending ministry of our Christ, our Lord, who will be crucified on the cross and then resurrected on the third day. And so we have this gospel today that tells us about picking up our cross and following Christ. And it's a tough message because it's a difficult thing to do in our lives. I had just recently listened to an audio podcast, an interview with a young man who was Orthodox. He grew up Orthodox and now he has now left the church. He's left the church because he has a lot of questions about what truth is, what really truth is. He couldn't find those answers. You know, he had compartmentalized his life so much. And we call this secularism, right? He compartmentalized it so much that church was just one small part of his life, and he was really influenced and educated by the world around him. And so when some of the things that the world teaches do not mesh up with what the church teaches, he had this, in a sense, of basically an identity crisis, if I were to sum it up. He didn't know what truth was. In fact, he was probably more gravitated to the truth of the world and what it all taught him. And what that world teaches is relativism and nihilism. Everything is relative. There's no real truth. It all depends. My truth is different than your truth. And there's no real eternal truth. And nihilism is that basically the same, that it's not only relative, but if there is actually my truth, your truth, there is no truth. That everything is a go. And so when you start sowing those seeds in your mind, you can see that you have kind of a traumatic experience if you are a believer in the church, because you start questioning a lot of things that were taught to you. It don't make sense. They don't line up to what the world is telling you and the environment that you are dwelling and living in. Now, why do I say this and bring this up today on the cross? Because I will tell you this, brothers and sisters, whether or not we can academically go through all the teaching of the churches and convince you that they were right or not, there's one thing I can tell you for sure that is absolutely true. It is the cross. It's true that we will suffer. We'll be oppressed. There will be injustice. Some of us will be inflicted by sins and passions. Some of us will be put down. It'll be a difficult life. We'll endure it. That's true. Anyone who, from the little kid on up, knows that the world's just not fair, right? There is no fairness in this world. No one can deny that. And so the cross is true. The cross that Christ is telling us to pick up and follow him with, it's absolutely, undeniably true. Life is difficult. And so what are we to do? If we cannot understand any of the faith of the church, or we cannot bring ourselves to believe it because, again, of these colliding ideologies in our life, we can at least understand that we can't escape suffering. Happiness is a fleeting thing. Once we attain it, it moves on again to something else. We need something else to keep us happy. It's a moving target, brothers and sisters. So all we can do is embrace the difficulties of our lives, pick it up, and embrace it and say, yes, I have to endure this. And I'm going to make myself better. I'm going to make my life better despite it. I'm not going to be resentful of the world. I'm not going to be resentful of my faith and my God because I have to endure this. No, indeed, I'm going to let it transform me. I'm going to let it transform me to somebody better, to somebody who I wasn't yesterday. I'm going to be a new person each day because of these difficulties that I have to endure. Because I'm going to courageously take them upon my shoulder and not cry, not say I seek justice or some kind of fairness in life. I'm going to pick it up and I'm going to endure it. And as the old saying says, I'm going to make lemonade out of the lemons that was given to me. That is what Christ is saying about the cross. That if you're going to be truly his follower, his disciple, that he doesn't want a resentful crybaby. He wants somebody who knows that, yes, life is difficult, and that I'm going to have to endure it and take it and transform those difficulties into blessedness. Not happiness, but blessings. Because God can bless it. He can turn anything around in our lives. Any difficulty, he can make a blessing. He's not going to make us happy. That's not what his that's not God. He's not up here just to make us happy, because that's a moving target, like I said. But he's going to bless us if we endure what he's given us. Some of this stuff is given to us because the world around us is fallen. It's not just God placing it on our shoulders. Some of it is because of our own doing, our own decisions in life. But it's okay. If it comes, we take it. We shoulder it, and we transform it into something good. We can transform our lives into something better. We can transform the people around us and lift them up. This is our duty as Christians. As Christians. So there's the truth, brothers and sisters. Life's hard. I don't know where you're at in the world, what your religion is, how you were brought up. You cannot deny that. That is the truth. Life is difficult. And it throws a lot of curveballs at us, and we don't know what's coming. But we take it as they come. And we do it because Christ knows that this is the only way to make meaning out of this suffering in our lives. It's the only way to make meaning out of it, is to transform it into something good. Take the bad and make it good. And he showed us the way. As we heard in the gospel, we know that he's going to do it too. That he did it. He endured difficulties in life, did he not? Our Lord, our Savior, God himself incarnate in this world, he, just like us, endured it all. Sickness, sorrow, injustice, pain, death, all of it. And so he's saying, listen, follow me because I'm going to show you the way to do it. I'm going to show you how to transform this bad into good. So today, brothers and sisters, that's the truth that we need to contemplate on. All the doctrines of the church, the social teachings of the church that maybe just are conflicting in our minds because we have compartmentalized our faith so much, because we've given so much attention to what the world is telling us is true and not what the church is. Above all, we know one thing. The cross is true. Suffering is true. Oppression is true. Injustice is true. And we shoulder it. And we make that bad into a good for us and for those around us to the best of our ability. And it'll be blessed. Just like the resurrection is a blessing. Death on the cross became a blessing. And all our hardships become blessings in some way. We may not understand it, but give it time and it'll be blessed. Just do not become resentful. Do not become despondent, because God will never put more on our shoulders than we can bear. I assure you, brothers and sisters. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.